Today, we are going to introduce another special usage of the Scail model. This special usage involves using the poses of multiple characters to generate a video. Typically, when we use Scail for video generation, it only involves a single character. However, in this workflow, you will notice that my reference image contains two characters. Of course, the driving pose also features two characters. Then, we can obtain a video like this. You can see the overall effect is quite excellent. Naturally, we can make the generated video even longer. In this workflow, we set the number of loaded frames to 176. Looking at the generation results, the effect is also very good. Additionally, we can use camera control models like Uni3C to manage the camera movement of the entire video. This way, it makes the entire video less rigid. The three examples I just gave are actually not the most critical part. The most important thing is how we generate a video with a two-person pose. Take a look. This involves many techniques. We will explain them to you one by one later. As we all know, Scail is a new model that uses poses to generate videos. Furthermore, it supports pose alignment and performs exceptionally well in terms of character consistency. Since we have already explained this model in detail in previous videos, we will just briefly mention its usage. You need to upgrade Qwen One video extension to the latest version. Next is the model download. There is a BF16 version and an FP8 version. You can choose different models based on your own computing power. I have also built the workflow on Running Hub, and you can access this platform through runninghub.ai. In the field of ComfyUI, Running Hub is an excellent online workstation. Whenever new extensions and models appear, it follows up immediately. You can register for Running Hub through the invitation link in my video description area to receive 1,000 free points. Additionally, you will get 100 points for logging in every day, allowing you to try out your own workflows. All right, next, let's first take a look at the Scail workflow. Let's look at the simplest one first. This workflow is simpler than the one in our previous video because the pose generation is not completed within this workflow. Here, we directly provide a pose map in the NLF format, which we have mentioned before. Similarly, we need to set its resolution. Please note that the default resolution for Scail is 512p, specifically 512 by 896. Next, we load and resize this pose map. We also need a reference image, which must be resized to stay aligned with our resolution. Then, we load the main model. Here, we are loading the Scail FP8 model. Moreover, we use the light X2V acceleration, LoRA-enabled block swapping, used the 1.2.1 VAE, and loaded our text encoder here. Similarly, we will use the clip vision encoder. Now, look at this next part. This is the most critical part of the entire workflow. First, we generate a predicate, and then we add conditions. The name of this node is very interesting. One video adds Scail reference embeds. It is used to load the corresponding reference conditions. Our basic vector is the empty vector we just generated. First, we need to add our reference image. Second, we perform visual encoding on our reference image and put it into the reference image slot. So all of these are about the reference image. Next is the reference pose. We take the generated embedding vector again and add the pose image into it. Everyone, please note that the N% should be set to 0.5. Don't set it too high. Next is the sampling. Qwen has developed a new version of the sampler here. It mainly separates the sampling options we commonly use from those we don't. For example, our commonly used sampling algorithms, schedulers, and sampling steps are all in one area. Then, the ones not commonly used, such as context options, are placed in the extra argument section. After sampling, you can see that the overall alignment of poses and characters is fine. The character consistency is also maintained quite well. However, there are also some drawbacks. When the bodies of two people are very close together, their actions like arms crossing through each other. Although it isn't particularly obvious, the hand of this woman passes directly through the body of the other woman. The main reason for this is caused by our pose map. In this pose map, because the two people are relatively close, many parts of their bodies are entangled. This was designed this way to show everyone this drawback. Since I have enabled the context sliding window here, we can make the number of generated frames larger. I'm using 176 frames here. So overall, this is a long video. This is the second point you need to pay attention to. The third point is the camera control. We connected a Uni3C option. Uni3C is a model based on 1.2.1 used to control the movement of the camera. We use a Uni3C node here to generate a corresponding embedding vector and add it to the sampling process. In this way, we can obtain a video with camera control. Note that adding Uni3C might disrupt the consistency of the entire scene. In this video, there is a background switch in the middle, even though the characters do not switch. At this time, you might consider adjusting the weight of Uni3C to be a bit smaller, or lowering the end percent a bit. Try to keep the overall scene consistent. So these are the three workflows regarding scail. However, the most important part is how the pose is generated. We eventually obtained a pose map like this from a reference video. As mentioned, the format is NLF. There are several key points to emphasize when generating a video with two characters together. The first is perspective consistency. The proportions occupied by these two characters in the video should be roughly the same. You cannot have one large and one small, otherwise one will seem far away while the other is close, which is unreasonable. We adopt this technique. I have a reference video and a configuration item setting the width, height, and frame count. For example, to generate 176 frames, I will first multiply this by 2 and extract double the number of frames. Then, I divide it into the first 176 frames and the last 176 frames. This ensures both characters are taken from the same video and are aligned in terms of perspective. After resizing, we get to the skillful part of the workflow. The biggest feature of the scail model is pose alignment, and we utilize this feature effectively. There are actually three images here. The first has both characters together, the second has only the left character, and the third has only the right character. I used Qwen Image to generate these, and then used Qwen Image Edit Plus to delete characters individually to get two reference images. Next, I take the first video and align its pose with the image using the nodes we previously used in scale. We used several models here, including the NLF model to predict the pose and DW pose to extract the skeleton. We extract the DW pose for both the reference video and the reference image. Ultimately, we get a video where the character is aligned specifically to the far left. Then we use the same method for the character on the right. Next, we use an image blend node to merge the images together, like layers in Photoshop, between additive and subtractive modes. You must choose the subtractive mode, either screen or soft light. This stacks the two together into one video. This method is very ingenious. While you might think of joining videos horizontally, it is difficult to maintain standard 9:16 or 16:9 ratios that way. You could also use video editing software to generate such a pose map. Through this test, you can see that scail is effective not only for single characters, but also for multi-character poses. Even when characters are close, most interactions are reasonable, and the overall feeling is good. What are you waiting for? Hurry up and try it yourself. Follow me to become someone who understands AI.